Hello there, and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Grimrock. I am the RNGenius, but you may call me Eric, and we left off over here in this area on the 10th floor? The 9th floor, I think? Somewhere around there, and right now we have to deal with the situation that I don't actually know where I am and what I have to do. Because right now it feels like there's not one path down, there's basically 100. And I have to figure out which one is right one, or at least for the moment I don't want to go down any paths. First of all, I want to actually, like, well, do something that makes sense, like explore this area. But then again, like, we've got all these paths right now. I can go in here and I can also go back and well, you see, there was that hole I can fall down in. That probably makes sense to go in there right now. I think it was over here and through this door, down this hallway. Okay, I wouldn't have needed to go down the hallway. But behind this door, there's a way down. And then we can fall down here as well. What do we have to fight here? Oh, friggin-tastic. Of course, my one shot misses. I forgot about these guys. Oh no. Don't get boxed in, Eric. I want to go through you. Thanks. Thanks, I want to go through here. I want to go through you, though. Uh-oh. We've gotten strong, though, so I would not be able to take care of these guys head-on. Never. There's only one remaining. That sounded like somebody died right there. Is that just me? Must be. Okay. Took care of these guys. Okay. That's fine. There's people who can play this game much better than myself because, actually, I don't use potions very much. Sadly. Like, I would be much better off if I used all these 32... potion thingies that I have, but no, I don't do that, because I'm a bloody moron. I'm a bloody, oh, that's the wrong button. I'm just bad at video games, that's basically the gist of it. I'm not good at this sort of game, and that is why, I've got a hiccups right now, I'm sorry. That is why I don't, oh. The broken mechanism controls the portal. From there, we can escape. I'm still too weak to move, but I'm glad you are making progress. I need to gather my strength so we can leave together. Almost gave him like a German accent right there. Give him the voice of the villain. Right. It's our friend. Give him the voice of the villain. I'm a moron. I drank something right there, by the way. So, now we're gonna go on. I think, like, it takes a lot of mana with Zandul's orb, or what it's called, to make use of the fireball all the time. Okay, that's where I came from. That's where I've already checked for secrets. Zandul. Nice name, by the way, bro. Zandul. Very good. That's a shuriken. That's two shurikens. They really like shurikens, huh? Those are not very good throwing weapons even, but that's okay. Mm-mm. I feel like my torch is gonna burn down soon, so I might as well do that. And milkreed is also always good for those speed potions. Oh. Oh-ho-ho. Don't forget about those speed potions. And that is milkreed and blood drop blossom. And then one more blood drop blossom for a different potion. So we do one of these, and the flask to get speed potion. And we do one of these and the blood drop blossom to get a mana potion for him. And then I pick up a steak and give it to him so he eats that. You're hungry? Eat a baked maggot. You are not hungry. You are particularly hungry. You eat a bag maggot as well. Sorry, RNGenius. You can deal with that, though. Should have taken the bone necklace with me. Ah. Oh, well. He really enjoyed having that around his neck, though. I would know because I'm basically him. Oh, that's a secret. Interesting. Shield of Elements. Well, evasion plus 10, resist fire, resist cold, resist poison, resist shock. A shiny shield that is embossed with the magical symbols of the four elements. Resist fire, strength plus 2, evasion plus 10. Okay. Yeah, goodbye, baby. Goodbye, we don't need you. Okay, so this was one secret and it closes off behind you. Okay, cool. That is that. There was another staircase downwards. Was there a secret as well? Gonna go back there. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I might as well save at the crystal as well. So I'm gonna go back there. And on the way there, I think that was a thing. Was it? Yeah, there was a way down here. So over here, I'm gonna touch the crystal again. Don't you dare touch the crystal, Eric. Sorry, bro, I did. Whatever to put there, I don't know. I don't know how to open this door either. Oh, that's probably the door you open with those two ornament keys, right? What's down here? Oh, man, another way down. Scroll. This level is sealed. Why? I really like this level, though. This level's not sealed. I don't want to go down. No. I don't know how. Can I not even turn around and stairs? You won't let me do that, game? That is very not nice of you. Now we created a bunch of auto-saves because I went down and up and down and up. But that's okay. That level is sealed, apparently, so we're not going to mess with that right now. I'm probably going to open that at some point, but we'll see. Seems like that's optional as well, though. You remember what the developers did with that. Well, the vault of the vault of the dude. Oh, I activated that already. Okay. Well, now we can continue onwards, though. Now I don't feel so bad about being here and going onwards. That is so totally that door. Because over here on the left, there was that crystal on the over right over there, basically, where I'm the middle of my screen. Right over there was that crystal. And that is the door. Okay. Do we want to go into the shrine? Or do we want to go into the caverns? I think it's time for the caverns. I really enjoy caverns myself, so I actually let's play the game called Cavern Kings. So basically that's my reasoning for going into the caverns. Hey. Whoa. Oh no. Oh. Beautiful. And we're gonna go back and sleep though. Not sleep, actually. We're just gonna go back and go around to that crystal. It's gotta be over there. Over here and then to the right. Oh, it's over here. Okay, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Full health. I can't believe I hit myself with a fireball. That's always a thing you're not supposed to do. Okay. Maybe that's not that door. I don't know. Caverns, though. Seriously. You saw the two ogres. I did. You can be sure there is actually two ogres over here. Yes. We're going to deal with them. We're strong. Let's just hope they don't, well, surprise us. Let's hope we are going to surprise them, though. Oh, that's a one hit. They can pretty much trap themselves, though. Did he see me? Oh, he so saw me. Oh, no. You're not gonna do that. Sorry, bud. I can't have you around blocking my path. I need a strong attack right here. Please stop it. Oh, decide already. There is an easy and a difficult way to deal with ogres. This is the difficult way. That's the easy way. Can you not hit your friend, please? Why wouldn't you do damage to your friend? You're really way too nice of a guy. Yep, that's how you do that. And then you turn all the way around. Come and run at me. Like a madman. And then you give me the chance to hit you in the back. Or maybe not. Or maybe you're just gonna give me my demise immediately because that little bug is attacking me. Hey, little buggy. Ugh. Okay. He was gonna attack me, but he didn't because he's stupid. Or actually because I got lucky. Same thing, really. Haha. yeah. I don't have any mana remaining. I don't like that very much. Give me mana. I can sleep right here. It's a safe place, obviously, with holes in the floor around. Oh, by now it's getting annoying how much mana I'm losing, but he is a combat caster, and he casts very fast, very quickly. So, that's why his mana's draining so much. That's okay, though. That's gonna be with my Minotaur as well when he gets to swords level 50 and can attack with his swords twice as fast. That's gonna be crazy. Oh, it's getting darker now. Note. Well, before we do that... Do that, do that. Space for four more notes. I've been wandering in the same area for a long time. My provisions are running out. But I think this cavern is my best bet for finding a hidden room. Or some creatures I could have food. I could hunt for food. Oh. It's a bad situation if... More. Hey, ogre. And I slept over there. Nobody noticed me. Are you gonna fall down that hole? Sadly, his AI is good enough to not. But even if, it would not be a good thing for me if he fell down that hole. Because otherwise I would have to deal with that after I fall down that hole myself. It's actually, preferable for him to do this. Can I actually hit him while he's running? I can. Backstab as well. Ah, no! I am a moron. Why doesn't it travel instantly? Please. Oh, please. I thought I had him there. That. When are those guys gonna be dead? Oh, there's one more of these insects. Switch puzzle, nice. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of stuff to explore, huh? Okay, that's fine. I'm happy about that. I'm not gonna fall down there yet because floor 11 is sealed, if you don't remember. It's sealed. Can't go there, it's sealed. Oh. It's more of those creatures. Toorum, why would you be starving, though? Oh, why is this door closed? Why would Toorum be starving, though? Like, the previous floor was the floor with those blue dinosaurs, and all of them dropped big, tasty steaks. Seriously. Huh. Okay. Where do I begin searching? Oh, that's a sack with stuff in it. What is that? Oh, bunch of stuff. Bunch of not that useful stuff, though. Cave nettle and a slime bell. Gonna put that thing on the floors again, and now we're gonna... Oh. Should've probably given that to him, huh? So Tarbeed, cave nettle, and slime bell is in there. Cool. Slime bell is for curing toxification, by the way, although I never do it. Okay, that's good to go. No secrets. I know there's one secret around here that I definitely want to find. 100% I need to find that. It might be the one thing I actually want to find. But I will find it. So I will... It's very interesting also. So you're gonna like me finding that. That's gonna be interesting for you. There's a pit root bread. There you go. What did that open? Nothing. Well, maybe I have to hit two buttons at the same time, and... Well, maybe that's one of them. Maybe it opens something way over there. I don't know. Important thing is... I might as well just deal with these guys now, right? I mean, why shouldn't I? That's two. Use the big fireball on those guys, and then... Do that, and... Nothing. Another one of Toorum's notes. Toorum. The placement of the pillars by the row of levers is most peculiar. I'll have to inspect them more closely. Okay. Placement of the pillars. Peculiar, you say. This room is also very peculiar. There's also... There were only a bunch of enemies in there, and that's it. Not a nice area. Inspect the walls. Don't fall down, Eric. Okay, inspect them over here. Nothing. Let's say the light is where the new area starts. So I'm gonna do a turn around here. I'm gonna loop. I'm gonna find a torch at some point as well. Not gonna use one of my own. Okay, that is also where the new room starts. So let's go to that torch over there, grab that, and then explore the other wall. Not that dark. Okay. And go over here, over this wall. Of course, completely. Yes, I do this. Sorry. I'm not sorry, actually. That is my type of style of gameplay, and this is the type of game where that is a viability. Looking at every single wall. What's in here? Oh, dinosaurs. That is food. That's a good resource. Although I don't know what is a good place to fight them. I never hit with a flurry of slashes because I always walk away. Why do you always walk away, Eric? Turn around, walk away. It's gonna be fine. That's a big chunk of food. I'm gonna take that with me. Then I'm gonna look in here. Throwing axe, don't need that, and nothing. I'm gonna close that door and sleep again, because my people are really down right now. Don't you even hear me? I think I might be a little quiet at times. I mean, I've got the microphone right in my face, so I don't know. That's okay. That's enough, I don't like sleeping that much. I mean, it's also annoying to my for myself, so yeah. Not that big of a sleepyhead right now. Doop-de-doop. The placement of the pillars is most peculiar. let's first of all ignore this for the second, but without that piece of advice, that is a really difficult puzzle to solve as well. So it wouldn't be very good to not solve that like that. But with the piece of advice, I mean, it's pretty much a joke. I'm unhappy. I found that one switch and it didn't do anything. One switch that does not do anything. That is peculiar, isn't it? Did I just not find the second one? Or am I stupid? I didn't notice what opened and closed again, huh? That opened. Now it closes. It's open. Oh. Note. Finally, I discovered a stash of supplies, but once I got in here, the wall closed shut behind me. I've been too confident in myself. I thought I knew how the rules of the dungeon worked. Toorum. Secret found. Remains of Toorum. Is that like... Oh, it's too heavy for you. Are you kidding? Don't be a baby. Do you get, like, any damage boost from this? It doesn't look like it. Long ago, decayed remains of a human. The bones have a strange aura. Do they? I don't really think so. I'm gonna carry them around, though, because it's Toorum. Tattered cloak. Don't need that. Everybody's carrying around a cloak. Note. My ink is starting to run dry, and I haven't had a crumb to eat in days. I can hear them whispering behind the walls. They knew I wasn't on their side. I'm too weak to walk. I'm trapped. If only I could have... Okay, there's something. Ancient axe. Oh, God. Interesting. Well, I have to end this episode now, though, so I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I will see you in the next episode as well. We're gonna explore theories more next episode, but I have to end it now. So, until next time, bye-bye.